Here at the Vault, we get a bunch of calls all the time, people wondering what deck is right for them. I'm here today to help you guys out in choosing the best deck for you. There's many different decks out in the market, as far as lengths and widths, all sizes. They all have different feels to them. One thing to take in consideration when choosing the right deck for you is what style of riding you're into and what style of riding you're going to progress and want to progress into. Typically, a deck longer than 20 inches is suitable for the street rider of the sport or someone that likes to flow around. The benefits of a longer deck is that you lock into ledges and rails and stay in that a longer period of time. You just have more foot space to move around on and balance on, which is beneficial for an older rider of the sport or someone that has a big foot, because foot space and foot room is key on a scooter deck. The deck width varies on the type of rider and what shoe size the rider is. Typically, a rider with a bigger foot wants to get a wider deck, or if the rider doesn't have a big shoe, they'd get one of the narrow decks or want to get the wider deck. Going wider is never bad. It's actually more beneficial because the deck itself hugs your foot. So by hugging your foot, the deck prevents any heels from scraping, as well as helps prevent from getting heel bruises, which all riders know and hate. Deck extrusions as well vary. You'd get a square extrusion, which helps lock in various grinds like 50-50s, Smiths, 5-0s, Crooks, as well as another extrusion would be an angled extrusion, which is suitable for pegs, which helps the pegs lock into whatever you're grinding, whether it's the ledge or a rail. Another issue is weight. Weight, a lot of riders tend to care about. There are decks out there that weigh about 2 pounds, 2 to 3 pounds, and there's decks that weigh 3 to 4 pounds. It's all on the rider. If the rider wants a really light deck that's not going to be doing a lot of impact and wants to do just grinds and ledges and technical tricks, then you'd be wanting a light deck. If a rider does a lot of impact, grinds, and wears the deck out, but still wants something steady underneath their feet, they'd get something a little more heavier, just so it's solid and secure. Head tube angle as well. Decks vary on head tube angle, anywhere between 81.5 degrees to 83 degrees, even 84. A steeper head tube angle prevents less looping out, as well as the bar gets higher, it makes it so the bar doesn't go straight into your chest. It pretty much sticks straight up, so it prevents your knees from hitting and gives you a more comfortable feel. So a lot of the taller or older riders of the sport would want to get a steeper head tube angle. Smaller riders, I'd probably say get a head tube angle, lean back a little bit more, just so it's more comfortable for you to step on. Decks mainly nowadays are integrated, so they all have machined cups, so you only have to deal with the bearings itself being pushed in. Not a big deal. Width, going back to the width, a wider deck is never bad. There are companies out there that make wide decks that weigh almost nothing. They're really lightweight, so you're able to have the benefits of a really light scooter, but have the benefits again of the width itself hugging your foot and giving you a better ride in terms of less heel drag and less heel bruises. Again, wider is never bad. Then again, narrow is never bad as well. It's all personal preference. You can go ahead and give us a call at the Vault Pro Scooters if you have any more questions. Go ahead and like, subscribe, comment below, let us know what you think. Till next time.